Hi friends, welcome to Learn and Explore. In this session, you will learn how to import text from an Excel datasheet to AutoCAD. In the previous video, I have shown you how to import XY coordinates or points from an Excel file to AutoCAD with a just copy and paste. As you can see, that file I have imported. Now I will import the text. That is the code and labels in this AutoCAD file. For that, I will import the lines and the all features in the next video. So keep watching this video till end and you will be able to create a topographical map. So if you like this video, please subscribe our channel. So now I'm starting it. So let's start it. So this was my file. As you can see that I had imported the points here in PO using PO command. Now I will import the text, the labels, MSL values and the code for each points. So to import the text, there is a format of four columns. First one is comment, which is used as minus text. The minus text is a AutoCAD command. So in the second column, there will be string ordering, string comma ordering, and the third column, the rotation angle. This rotation angle is the angle of text, so it will be zero. And in the fourth column, the text which you want to import. So in the command line, I will insert the command minus text. And one more thing, if you type only minus text, then it will so an error. So you have to first put first inverted comma then minus text. Okay, so in the second column I am using the formula equal to B5 and colon comma and C5, yes, for the formation of string ordering. This is also I had discussed in the previous video. See in the description you will find the link. Rotation angle 0 and text is first import the text code. So this is I have created these formulas and now I'm dragging the each cells to the end. That's it. So this is the formula of four columns we have to create first to import the text. And I'm adjusting the rows and columns. So these are the four columns. Now I will go to AutoCAD to create a layer where I will import the see in this video I had imported that points in the part one. Now I'm creating a layer, separate layer for the text. So I'm giving the name as text, color current, okay, and setting as active layer. Now close. So I have created the layer and so now I will import the text here. See, the points have already been imported. Now going to Excel file and you have to copy the four column. I am taking two rows for the verification that my text has been imported in right manner or not. So I'm copying just two columns first and just you have to do right click on the command bar and paste. See, the text has been imported but the height is too large. So and one more thing, before applying the formula you have to set the text style first in AutoCAD. So you have to format the text style first. For this the command is ST enter or you can go to format menu, okay, and then you can go for text style. So if you type ST enter then you will find the text style, or otherwise go to format menu and text style. Here you will, I'm just font name giving as Times New Roman, and the height I am giving is 1. One. So close means 0.5. Now I will copy the same and right click in the command bar and paste. See, my text has been imported because I had given the text size as 0.5, because in the previous video I had given the point height as 0.5, so I am giving the same height, but I want that the text will appear in next to the point. This is overlapping the point. So what I will do, if I add some value in the string, that is the text height is 0.5 text size. So in the formula I will edit something. What I will edit is in the Excel cell ID, in the string cell ID is B5. With the B5 I will add some values. I'm adding 0.5 to shift the coordinate of the text. Okay, and nothing is the same. For this you have to do within the bracket you have to add the 0.5 value. Now I'm again copying that to cells and right click, now paste. See, yes, now the points has been imported in a perfect manner. The text has been imported in a perfect manner. So you can choose the textile for 0.4 if you think that the text is again large. So I'm taking as 0.4. Now I will import the all text with just a single click. See, I'm going to Excel again. Now I will copy all the four columns till the data end. I have lot of data and I'm copying all the data. I'm going to AutoCAD and right click on the command bar and paste. See, the points are importing. Yes, all the points has been imported. I'm zooming the drawing, you can see. See, the each code of the each points has been imported. I had given the replacement value of each thing as 0.05. For this, the text has been imported at a movement of in x direction 0.5. And what next? Next, I will import the levels of each points just below the code. So for that, what I will do is I will generate another formula for the labels. So copying these command lines, copy. So I will import the labels. I will import the labels now. Same, I am using first inverted comma, then minus text text, that is my command, and the string equal to cell ID of string and double inverted comma, then double inverted comma, then and cell ID of nothing, enter. And the rotation angle will be same, so I'm putting is as 0, and the text, now the text will be equal to the levels which I will import the RL section. Yes, so I had created another formula. I'm now hiding this to understand you, so that you can understand easily. So I have created the four columns again to import the RLs. Now I will drag it to till the end. So see, the four columns are there. Now I'm dragging all the cells till the end of my data. You can see that I had a data of 280 numbers. You see the rotation angle was, so I have changed it to 0. Now and for example I'm choosing two rows first and same, right click and paste whatever. See, these points, the RLs has been imported, but the text has been imported and overlapping with the code, but I wish the labels would be here. So for this, what you have to do is to find out the replacement value of A in the x direction and the y axis. So see, in the x direction the value is 0.5, see, almost 0.5 or 0.55. In the north direction the value is 0.5 or 0.6. So what I will do, I will edit that Excel formula. There I will add some value in the xing with the easting value and deduct some value from the northing value. So within bracket I'm adding 0.5 with the easting value and from the nodding value I'm deducting 0.6. Let's see what happened. So I have edited this formula, I had changed the easting and value replacement values. Now I'm, for example, I'm copying two rows and paste it here. See, the points has been imported, the text has been imported, but the replacement is I think it can go further apart direction. So if I take deduct the value point in replace of 0.6 as 0.55, then it will adjust. So I am putting is as 0.5, which I will deduct from the northing value. Now I'm copying all the sets, data sets, four columns, and same, going to AutoCAD and right click and paste. See, yes, now you are done. All the text has been now imported what you wanted. So this is your data, and now you can easily make topographical map. See the road right side points, the road LHS, electric post, platform wall. In the next video, I will import the lines and the features. So keep watching our channel and you will find that how to import lines from an Excel dataset to AutoCAD. See, this is a railway line, and if you want to join the railway lines, then see the next video. Then I will show you how to join the railway lines with using only Excel, just copy and paste. So you can able to make a topographical map from any Excel dataset. Thank you for watching, guys. See you in the next video. With all the best. With best wishes from Learn and Explore team.